In this video, we will see how to draw the parabola by using rectangle method. Now the problem is a ball is being thrown in air attains 100 mm height and covers horizontal distance of 150 mm on ground. Draw the path of the ball, which is known as projectile, and the projectile will be the parabola. Now, when the ball is being thrown into the air, that means what? It is covering a 100 millimeter distance in the vertical way. And when it comes to the ground, at the same time, it covers a distance of 150 millimeter, a horizontal distance. This is the steps which is to be followed for drawing the parabola by using rectangle method. Now, first we will draw a rectangle of 100 millimeter by 150 millimeter. The vertical is 100 mm and the horizontal is 150 millimeter. Now, what we will do? We will divide this rectangle in two equal part, in such that this 150 millimeter horizontal length will divide into 75 millimeter and 75 millimeter. Now, the next step is to divide this 100 millimeter in six equal part and this 75 millimeter in six equal part. So we cannot simply divide 100 in six equal parts. As we know, 100 divided by six, we get something 16.66 millimeter. So that is not possible to take in scale and divide easily. So what we do for dividing any line, let us say this is a line. So I want to divide this line in six equal part. Let us say this line is of 100 millimeter and I want to divide in six equal parts. So divide by six. So I'm getting 16.67 millimeter, I think roughly near about. So what I will do, I will draw a line which is at an angle of 0 to 90 degree. Okay, we draw a line, inclined line, to this line which we want to divide at an angle of 0 to 90 degree. But normally we take 30 to 45 degree. Normally we take, because we don't draw like this line. We don't draw like this line. So normally we take 30 to 45 degree line. So randomly we draw a line which is near about 30 degree, 40 degree. Now, no need to measure that angle. Now, the next step is to divide this inclined line in six equal part. In how many equal parts you want to divide the actual line, in the same way you have to divide the line, which the inclined line which you have drawn to that vertical or horizontal line, in the same equal part. So let us take any distance, any x distance in the rounder, and simply divide this inclined line in six equal part. So 1, 2, 3, this is 4, this is 5, then after the last one is 6. Now the next step is to join the end point with this end point, and after that simply draw the parallel lines through the marked point. You can see like this. So in this way, what we can say, yes, we have divided the line in six equal parts. This is my first part, then second part, then third part, fourth, fifth, and sixth part. So in this way, any line can be divided in any n number of part. Okay, if this is a horizontal line, then we draw a horizontal line. We draw a line which is at an angle of 30 to 45 degree. Randomly draw any line. Let us say we want to divide this line in 5 equal parts. So simply we will take any distance in the rounder and we will divide this line in 5 equal parts. Then simply join the end point with this end point. Then after, you have to draw the parallel lines. So in this way, you can see the line has been divided in 6, 4, 5 equal parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. In this case also, this vertical line should be divided in 6 equal parts. So this is how we divide in 6 equal parts. Simply draw a line in at an angle of 30 to 45 degree randomly, and that line should be divided in 6 equal parts. And you have to join the last point. Then you have to draw the parallel lines. Now you have to divide this 75 millimeter also in 6 equal part. If this line, vertical line, has been divided into 6 equal part, then this line should also be divided in 6 equal parts. Let us give the naming 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. In the similar way, the naming should be given over here also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then 6. Now we will join these 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with this endpoint. Okay, like this. 2 has been joined on the same point, 3 on the same point, 4 on the same point, and 5 on the same point. 6 is already joined on the same point. Now we have to draw a vertical line from this point number 1. Right side rectangle has been divided in the similar way in 6 equal parts. Okay, we can directly take roller scale and we can draw these lines. We can directly mark these lines. Can take this point to this point distance, or 1 to 2 distance, and in the rounder, and we divide this line in 6 equal parts. So in the similar way, you have to join 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 all the points with this end point. Now the next step is what, that is a very important step. We have to draw vertical lines from these points. So vertical line from point number 1 and inclined, and inclined line from point number 1. Wherever intersects, that gives the point. Same vertical from 2, inclined line of 2, vertical from 3, inclined line of 3, vertical from 4, inclined line of 4, then 5, similarly for 6. Okay, 6 point will lie over here. Now on the, and in this similar way on the right side also. So now we can mark the point. 1-1 intersecting is over here, 2-2 intersecting over here, 3-3 intersecting over here, in the similar way 4-4. 5-5 intersecting over here, and 6-6 intersecting over here, in the similar way on the right hand side also. Now we will use the French curve and we will draw a smooth curve passing through these points. And after drawing the curve, whatever the locus we are getting, that is whatever the projectile we are getting, that is known as the parabola. So this is how we draw the parabola by using the rectangle method.